Exactly. Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Welcome to Marinize Powerhouse Team Review and Training Center. Welcome po sa amin pong ginaganap na free REE and RME online mentoring. Ito po'y live na mentoring program. No? This is the only review center na nagbibigay po ng libreng mentoring program. So, ang setup po natin dito, mga ka-werpa, ay question and answer portion na pinapadala po ng ating mga umaaten sa ating Zoom class. No? Magandang hapon po sa ating mga viewers, sa ating Facebook Live. Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. No? Nikayat namin kayo na mag-join kayo dito sa aming Zoom class para magkaroon din po kayo ng chance makapag-send in ng inyong mga katanungan. No? And then the following day, madi-discuss po namin yan. Ito'y ginaganap namin every Tuesdays and Thursdays, no? So, bali 4 to 6 p.m. na po natin ito ginaganap, no? Kasi meron pa po tayong special webinar ng 6 o'clock onwards. And then, every Sunday, 11:30 to 1 p.m. po natin ginaganap ito. Ito po'y live na activity na ginaganap, no? Free mentoring na tinulik sa mga ating mga kawerpa, no? So, tutulungan po namin kayo, no? Libre po ito, wala po kayong kailangang bayaran, no? Makinig lang po kayo diyan. Okay? So, sa ating mga Facebook viewers, no? Good day everyone, no? Magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. So, just in case, no? We upload this in our YouTube channel, so there may be a foreigner or non-Filipino students will watch our video. Welcome to our review center. No? My name is Engineer Reggie Marinay. You can call me Kuya Reg. No? Kuya means a big brother, no? in our country, in the Philippines. So, I'll try my best for you to understand the lecture. There are some portions of my lecture I'll be speaking in English so that you may understand our discussion also to our non-Filipino audience. No? Whether you are American, European, African, so I'll be speaking also in English. Okay, let's go on to our first question. Okay, our first question came from Mr. Jonel Tepait. Okay, is he connected, partner? Yes. Sir Jonel, put your thumbs up. Okay, so there he is. His first question is this. What is the maximum rating of the molded cage circuit breaker to protect 10 horsepower squirrel cage induction motor rated at 230 volts, 3-phase, 60 hertz with a full load rating 28 amperes? Okay, so we are given already the full load rating, no? This make it easier. Okay? So, mapapadali ito kasi given na yung ating full load rating, or this is what we call the full load ampere of the motor. Okay? Actually, our only basis is this 28 amperes. Okay? What is the size of the maximum rating of the molded case circuit breaker? So, always remember, if we are sizing a circuit breaker or a fuse, we are already sizing the maximum, no? The maximum rating. So, let's say this is our motor. Okay? Based on the National Electrical Code in US and also based on the Philippine Electrical Code in our country, no? It's just the same provision, no, in terms of sizing this circuit breaker. So, we are talking here of a licensure exam, no, board exam pinag-uusapan natin dito. In board exam, no, if we are sizing a circuit breaker, this circuit breaker, our multiplier is 2.5 multiplied by the full load amperes. That's how are you going to size. That is the size, maximum size of the circuit breaker. But if you are sizing a fuse, Let's say you are sizing a fuse. Okay, this is a fuse. What is the size of the fuse? The size is 3 multiplied by the full load amperes. That is, okay? So, I want to give you the formula of the full load ampere of the motor. Let's say our motor is single phase. So, the full load ampere of the motor, the full load ampere is actually our line current. That is the line current, full load line current of the motor. Meaning, the current that will flow here. That is your input current. That is your line current that is equal to the full load ampere. Okay? Although the line current, it can be under load, it can be overload. Okay? So, we have this formula. We have here horsepower times 746 divided by the voltage multiplied by the efficiency multiplied by the power factor. So, this is our formula for the single-phase motor. Take a look here. So that is our formula for the full load ampere. For the case of the three-phase motor, this is single-phase. For the case of the three-phase motor, our full load ampere, which is our line current, that is equal to the horsepower times 746 divided by square root of 3 multiplied by the line voltage. That is the voltage, the line voltage to be specific, multiplied by the efficiency multiplied by the power factor. So this is our formula in getting the line current. So ito po ang ating formula. Okay? So, we are given here a three-phase, no? But, the easier thing here in your question is that the full load ampere is already known. Binigay mo na to, no? Kajunel, 28 ampere, no? 28 ampere. Kaya, madali na lang yan, no? So, how is this? We have here the size of, let us have now the size of the circuit breaker. Okay, because the question is the maximum rating of the molded case circuit breaker. So, our circuit breaker is equal to 2.5 multiplied by the full load ampere. So, we have here 2.5 multiplied by 28 is your given. And I will calculate this. So, our answer is 2.5 times 28. The answer is exactly 70 amperes. 70. So, that is my answer to your question. No? And that would be letter, 70 ampere is exactly letter C. Okay? Kajunel, ito ang sagot natin sa iyong katanungan, 70. Okay? 70. Now, I want to, yes, sir. Yes, sir. I want to explore your question so that you will learn something. Okay, I will explore something here. Just in case you have a 10 horsepower, 230 volts, 3-phase. I will calculate the full load ampere. Full load ampere is equal to, according to the three-phase formula here, so we have here 10, then times 746, then square root of 3, what is the voltage? The voltage is 230 volts. Okay. I will just assume with the efficiency here, so, efficiency tsaka power factor, no? Halimbawa, no? Let's say, for example, our efficiency is 85%. So, meaning it is 0.85. Okay? Then, let's say our power factor is 0.8. So, I will put here 0.8. Okay? So, let's see what is the full load ampere. No? Let us see here. So, we have 10 times 746. Then, you press divided by. In your calculator, you press divided by square root of 3. Square root of 3. Okay? Then, you press again divided by. For me, it is easier, no? After divided by square root of 3, then you press again divided by. Okay? 230. Then, another divided by 0.85. And then again, divided by 0.8. And our answer is 27.538 or rounded up to 54 ampere. So that is 27.538574.22. Okay, which is quite near to your 28 ampere here, right? You see? Okay, pag ni-round off natin to 28 eh, no? Okay? Although I just assume the efficiency here and the power factor. It's not given in the problem. You know, it happens in the licensure exam, no? Even in the college exam, no? Let's say your professor has insufficient data. Sometimes you have to make some trouble. We call this as a troubleshooting. No? Troubleshooting. You have to make a estimated or a wise, your wisest guess. No? Okay? If we mean estimate, you should think your best idea or your the nearest to a reality, what I mean. No? Kumbaga, malapit sa katotohanan, no? Kumbaga, kung mag-assume ka. Okay? Ito, malapit sa katotohanan to. Eh. This is near to a reality that you can have an 85% efficient for your motor. Power factor, of course, that's possibility. Okay? So, we have 27.54, which is near to your 28, no? Are given here is 28. So, our answer here is 70 ampere, no? For this problem. Is it okay? Now, Sir Junel? Sir Junel? Is it okay? Speak in English? Okay? Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so here is another question from Sir Junel Tepait. No? Sir Junel Tepait. Okay, he is connected there. Okay. So, here he is the second question. Calculate the current taken by the motor at 440, having an efficiency of 90%. Moreover, the motor is like a pump which slips. This will become 2,400,000. I think there is a typographical error in this when I looking at your problem. Initially, I'm solving your problem. So, I think it's only 240,000. So, I'll share with you. 240,000 per hour. Okay? That is the flow rate, third rate of the pump. Okay? To a height of 30 meters is given to be 80% efficient. So, 80% efficient. 80% efficient. So, I'll show to you the simple diagram of this problem. So, we have a motor. Remember, we have a motor here. Okay, so this is our motor. We have an input power to our motor. Then the motor, this drives a pump. Huh? So let's say this is our pump. Then this would leap water. Okay, there is a certain head. Huh? Ito, meron siyang certain height. There is a certain height that you are going to lift the pump. There is a certain head. Let's say from this point, okay, let's say from this point up to this point, it's called this as height H. Height H. Okay? That will be our height H. Okay. Remember that this is the power input to your motor. This is the power output of the motor. Your power output of your motor is your power input to your pump. No? Power input to your pump natin to. No? So, the power input to our pump is the input power here, then we have the power output of the pump here. This is the power output of the pump. So we may say that the efficiency of the motor is equal to, okay, the power, the efficiency of this motor. That is power output of the motor over power input in the motor. The efficiency of the pump is power output over power input of the pump. Okay? Always remember that the power output of the motor is equal to the power input to the pump. Yung lumabas na power sa motor, yun din yung ipapasok mong power sa pump, no? Tawag namin sa construction diyan, bomba, no? Yeah, sa bomba. Okay? So, ito yung pump mo. Okay, yung bomba mo. Lilip mo yung tubig na ganun. Okay. I will give you the straight formula, no? So, this is the straight formula in getting the power output of the pump. This is the power output of the pump. power output of the pump. So, power output of the pump is the formula. Mg mass to gravity multiplied by the height. This is actually our potential energy. Mg is mgh. Remember that. In physics, potential energy equals mgh. Equal to mgh. Mgh. Okay. So, over, that is our formula. What is our mass? Ano ba yung mass na? Okay. Error here, this should be 240,000. 240,000 is in kilogram of water per hour. This is in kilogram per hour. Take note that the mass is in kilogram. Okay? So, I'm here. Gram per unit of time. So, this is kilogram per 1 hour. Ito ang ibig nun. No? This in 1 hour, the mass of water, okay, is 200,000 kilograms. It's being lifted by pressure pump. Okay, please open your camera. Okay, so we're having some technical difficulties in our internet connection. Just please listen first, no? Please listen. You can write it down, no, in your sheets. Okay. 240,000 kilogram per hour. Then our g is acceleration due to gravity. So is okay. Okay, clear na, real time na ba? Okay, okay na. Our G is 9.81, no? Meters per second. I will put the 9.81 meters per second square. That is our G. And our height is 30, no? What is the unit? 30 meters, no? 30 meters. So that is given in the problem. Yes, 30 meters. So this is the height. This is the height. Okay? Okay, I'll just continue. Okay, mgh then divided by the time is 1 hour. So, and then here, take note here, no? We have to take note of this. The power output of the pump, it will become what? This should be the units. This should be the unit. The mass is in kilogram our body is in a meter per second square, our height is in meters, our time is in seconds. That should be that the power output of the pump is in watts. We will convert the 1 hour into seconds. So this is 3600 seconds per hour. So the hour will cancel. Okay. So that this will be second. So we already followed our standard format here. So this is the mass is in kilogram. The G is in meters per second square, and the height is in meters. The time now will already be in seconds. So we can now have the watts, because remember that the kilogram meters per second square is our newton. Okay, newton meter is joules. So that will become joules per second is. Always remember that per second is watts. So therefore, the power output of the pump is equal. Let us calculate this. 30,000 times 9.81 30 divided by 3600. Okay. So our answer here is 19620. That will be in watts. Okay, let's go now to the power input of the motor. Over the efficiency of the motor times the efficiency of the pump. That should be our formula. Okay? Okay. So, what is the power output of the pump? 19620. The efficiency of the motor is given as how much? 90%. So, 0.9. And then we have 80% of the pump. So that will be equal to divided by 0.9, then divided by 0.8 equals. So that will be 27,250. What is this 27,000? This is the power input of the motor. That is the 27,250 here. Okay? Always remember that if it is single phase, there's no given basically. So I will assume that it is a single phase. There's no given power factor. I will assume, although this is not realistic, but one. The assumption is one. No? Para lumabas yung sagot. No? So, the assumption is one here. Ganun ang ginagawa sa board exam. Eh. No? Walang given tayo kasing ano rito eh. Power factor dito. So, paano yun, sir? Always remember that the power input is simply our power, which is equal to the voltage times the current times the power factor. If it is 3-phase, put here square root of 3. Okay? That is the basic formula of the power input. It is simply BI times cosine theta. Okay? Always, that is always, the power input to your motor is BI times cosine theta, if that is single phase. If that is 3-phase, square root of 3 times the line voltage times the line current times the power factor. Now, as I've said, our power input of the motor is equal to VI times the power factor. So therefore, our I here will be equal to what? Power input, okay, of the motor divided by the voltage, okay, divided by the power factor, okay, and that will be equal to 27 to 50, okay, divided by the voltage. How much is our voltage? 440. Then times 1, power factor assumed to be 1. 27 250 divided by 440. So our answer is approximate 61.93181818, or approximately 62 amperes. Okay? This is an engineering board problem, actually. REE board question, no? This problem. Okay? Medyo, ano na to, hindi, medyo minimal na to kung lalabas to sa Master Electrician board, no? Pang, more on pang electrical engineering tong question na to, no? So, ito'y lumabas sa REE board exam, this particular questions, no? So, this is the solution, okay? Maybe some in Master Electrician, the, sometimes just the question is find the current given the power input. Okay? Just simply divided by. So, that's it. No? So, ganun lang siya kadali. No? But in this quite a long procedure, in this calculation, this is being given in the Registered Electrical Engineer Licensure Exam. No? Okay? That is. And this is my answer. Tower Pang Junel, 62 amperes. No? Maybe you could watch the video over and over again. Okay? So that you will master this topic. No? So, of course, that is better. You are studying a harder question. No? So that's better. No? Okay?
Thank you po.
Okay, okay na. Tayo. Tower Pang Junel. Okay, Pang Junel. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. Okay, I get this one question from the Facebook. So please take a look here from REE and RME Board Exam Problems and Solutions. So this is the name of their group. No? Okay. So siguro tayo, gagawa din tayo. Not siguro, surely gagawa po kami ng grupo naman ng mga nagre-review din. No? Tawagin nating REE and RME Mentoring, no? Wala pang ganung pangalan sa Facebook. So, maggagawa po tayo, mga kawerpa, no? Okay? So that we can serve you better, no? Okay, this question came from Michael Angelo Gunay. This, here is his question. Three single-phase transformers are bumped delta Y. So, I will put here delta and Y. Okay, delta and Y. There. What should be the required turns ratio of each transformers to transform 10 MVA from 230 kV? 230 kV is a line-to-line voltage, not 230. 230 kilovolts. 24160 volts. 4160 volts. Okay? The question is the required turns ratio. What is the required turns ratio? I got this question because this was given in the board examination. So there's a possibility this will be given again in REE, even in RME board exam, board examination. Okay. The transformation ratio or ratio of transformation, we have this formula, our A, this is for three-phase. Take note, the transformation ratio for three-phase, that is equal to B phase primary over B phase secondary. Okay? There. This is also equal to N1 over N2. Number of turns in the primary, kung ilang ikot ng wire yon, number of turns on the primary divided by the number of turns on the secondary. And then, we have here I phase secondary. This should be secondary divided by I phase primary. Did you remember in single phase transformer we discussed before? No, the transformation ratio is 1 1 2 2 2 1. Okay, again, this is 1 1 2 2 2 1. 1 1 2 2 2 1. Okay, so the basis is the phase voltage. The phase voltage, remember that we should know the basic of three phase voltages in delta. Remember, let us recall this. In delta, our line voltage is equal to phase voltage, isn't it? In Y, our line voltage or line to line voltage is equal to square root of 3 multiplied by the phase voltage. The phase voltage is what we call the coil voltage. Coil voltage. Remember, this 230 volts is a line to line voltage. That is our VL. Okay? To be specific, this is our VL on the primary side. This should be 1. Then if I have a voltmeter here, this is the V phase on the primary side. No? The voltage in the coil. No? Mismo yung volt tayo sa coil mo. So, this is your volt V phase secondary. There. Phase voltage. The 4160 is the line voltage at the secondary. Okay? We just have to get B phase 1 and B phase 2. So, our B phase 1 is, what is this? B phase 1, take note. Obviously, our B phase 1 in delta, BL is equal to B phase, right? Our BL 230. Therefore, our B phase is also 230 because they are just in parallel. Remember, if there's a voltmeter here and the voltmeter here, no? These are just in parallel, equal voltages here, assumed to be balanced, no? If I will put the voltmeter here, so the voltmeter here in this coil will be in parallel with the line voltage, no? That's why they are equal, no? Okay? This is what I mean. If you are to transfer here and to transfer here, the line voltage will be equal to the phase voltage because they are in parallel. In Y, this is the line voltage to get the phase voltage. This is the B phase secondary. To get the phase voltage here, this will become B phase will be equal to BL over square root of 3. Okay? So, therefore now, we are now ready to have this transformation ratio for 3 phase. Okay. What is the B phase primary? 230 volt. 230 kV. K means 1,000. Okay? Then divided by B phase secondary according to the formula. This is the B phase secondary. We have to divide the 4160 by square root of 3 because of this formula here. VL over square root of 3. Huh? Because of this formula. Okay? So, because of this formula, VL over square root of 3, that is why we have here 4160 over square root of 3. Should be square root. Okay? So, kukuhanin mo muna to. Okay? I-divide mo to. Then, siya mo i-divide dito. Okay? Well, this is easy. No? We can go directly in our calculator. Or we can also make it 230,000. We can make it times square root of 3. Divided by 4160. So our answer is 95.72. 95.76, I mean. 95.76. 6242446. That is the answer. Okay, so this is the turns ratio also, which is the ratio of the primary to the secondary turns. This is my answer to this to Mr. Michael Angelo Gunay. Okay? Always remember that our basis, okay? That our basis is our phase voltage, the phase value, okay? The phase value. So, we have here the phase current, and we have the phase current on the secondary side divided by the phase current on the primary side, no? If I mean the phase current on the primary side, meaning that is the current in the coil here. Always remember that. I phase primary. What about the phase current on the secondary? This one. The current flowing in the coil. Huh? Yung mismong dumadaloy sa coil. That is our I phase secondary. Mismong dumadaloy sa coil yon, yung I phase secondary natin. No? Okay? Well, if you want to get our current, no? So our S is equal to square root of 3, line voltage times line current, no? Our line current is equal to S divided by square root of 3 multiplied by the line voltage. It's up to you whether you want to get the primary current or the secondary line current. Okay? It's up to you, no? Nasa sayo yun, no? So, what do I mean? If you will put this as 1, make this as 1. If you make this as 2, make this as 2. It's already given there so that you can calculate now for the current. But I want to complete my answer here, no? Actually, I am already complete, no? So, sobrahan ko pa, no? So, it's already complete because we already get the answer here. So, in delta, remember this. Our line current is equal to square root of 3 multiplied by the phase current. That is the basic of three-phase system. No? In Y, okay, in Y, our line current is equal to phase current. So, always remember this formula. No? Always remember this. That is for Y and this is for delta. Connection of this transformer. Okay? So, these are the basic formula. No? Okay? So, those are some additional information you can get from this question. No? Okay, let's go now to our next question here. Okay, thank you. Okay, the next question came from Mr. Lance Michael S. Lakdaw. So he sent us a question, no? I will answer it in detail, no? But I already showed the solution on the TV so that you can we can save our time discussing this problem. Is he connected, partner? Anyway, actually he is our reviewee, no? But to our Facebook viewers, no, anybody can ask question, no? Not only our students in our review center, no? Kahit sino pwedeng magtanong po. Basta mag-join lang po kayo dito sa aming Zoom class. Welcome po, kahit sino po sa inyo, welcome po, no? Welcome na welcome po kayo, mga kawerpa, no, na mag-join dito. Okay, sagutan naman natin itong mathematics. No? Baka sabihin ng iba, puro pang electrical yung ating sinasagutan. No? Hindi po. No? Ang sasagutan po natin ay math, ESAS, EE, technical subject, PEC. No? Cover po natin lahat yan. No? So, pwede kayo magpadala ng inyong mga katanungan. Okay. So, actually, clarification lang naman yung kay Mr. Lance Michael Lakdaw, no? Okay. He's not connected, partner. He's not connected. Anyway, he is classmate of Kawer Pangalan, Tablada. Okay. Sige. Siya muna. I-highlight mo si Kaalan. Okay, Kaalan. Sige, ikaw muna mag-substitute kay Lance, no? Actually, simple lang naman yung tanong niya, no? Okay. Simple na mahirap. So, this is the question, no? This is the question. Okay. In this problem, no? Paki-close up natin 'to. Kahit itong portion lang na 'to. Sige pa. Maximize natin, maximize. Okay na? Nakikita na nila. The question here is, nababasa ba? What is the distance of the line? No, ano, natakpan dito. 4x minus 3y, I think this is plus 5. I think this is plus 5, no? It's equal to 0, tama ba? Okay? From the point 4 and 2. From the point 4 and 2. So, that is his question in this problem, no? So let us sketch, no, this figure. So we have here 4x minus 3y, no, 4x minus 3y plus 5 equal to 0, right? Equal to 0. That is the equation of our line. Take note, our x here is our a. This will become negative y is our b, and this is our c. Okay? Our c. So, let us have our line. Okay? Let us have our line here. No? Okay? If let's say if y is equal to 0, what is the value for x? Okay. So we have here our 4x minus 3, our y will become 0 plus 5, that's equal to 0. So therefore, this will just become 0. So we have here 4x. So that is equal to, that is 5. Let us transpose negative 5. So therefore, our x here is negative 5 over 4. Negative 5 over 4. So this is our x, negative 5 over 4. Okay, negative 5 over 4 is approximately 1.25. Let's say it should be negative, no? X is negative 5 over 4. Then, of course, your y will be equal to 0. So, this is our x-intercept here. Somewhere here. Okay? So, the coordinate of this point is negative 5 over 4, then y 0. Okay, if x is equal to 0, what is the value for y? If x is equal to 0, so this is 4 times 0 minus 3y, no? So we have plus 5, that is equal to 0. So, of course, this will just become 0. Our y here will become, let us transpose this negative, will become positive. So, we have here our 5 that is equal to, let us transpose this. Negative will become positive, 3y. Therefore, our y here will be equal to 5 thirds. No? Magiging 5 thirds siya. 5 over 3. 5 thirds is how much? 5 divided by 3, 1.67. Okay? When x is 0, and then we have 1.67. Okay, we have here 1, 2. Say it's somewhere here. Somewhere here. So, 2 points determines a line. No? That's the first postulate, right? There you are. So, this is now the line. Ito yung pinaka-line natin. But the location is, the point is at 4 and 2. Where is this point? We have here 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we have 1, 2. It is somewhere here. So, ito yung point natin na 4 and 2. So, if we are to get the perpendicular distance, this is our perpendicular distance. That is our distance. Okay? So, that is our perpendicular distance. Actually, the question of Lance is, why is this becomes negative? Bakit daw naging negative ito? Remember, this is the distance from a point to a line. This is the formula. Huh? Ax plus by sub 1, x sub 1, this is y sub 1 plus c, divided by the plus or minus square root of a squared plus b squared. Okay? That is the distance of a point to a line. No? Okay. So, take note, where the ambiguous sign in the denominator follows the sign of B. So, don't you know that I also look the meaning of the word ambiguous sign? Ambiguous. Pwede ba yun mapakita? Tinignan. Pwede natin mapakita sa kanila yung partner. I-type mo yung ambiguous. What is the meaning of ambiguous? No? You type ambiguous meaning. Pwede nilang makita yun. Ayoko kasi sa akin lang manggaling, ano? Let's have some research here. The author of the book or reviewer used the word ambiguous sign. No? Kasi ang tanong ni Lance actually, bakit ito, sir, negative? Hindi ba dapat, sir, positive? Okay. So, punta muna tayo dito. Remember, the author used the word ambiguous. Ambiguous meaning open to more than one interpretation. No? Sabihin, nakikita ba nila yan, partner? Pakita mo sa kanila, 100% mo. 100% yan. Okay. O, tingnan nyo, mga ka-werpa, pwedeng i-highlight yan. Yung ginawa mo kanina, open to more than, yan, lakihan mo na lang. Pakita mo sa araw, nakita nila yung araw mo. Okay, open to more than one interpretation. A double meaning. Double meaning, ano ibig sabihin? Parang, dalawang ano, no? Double meaning, dalawang kahulugan. Then there is a word there, the second meaning is unclear or inexact. No? A choice between alternative has not been made. No? Kumbaga, hindi pa eksakto 'yan, 'di ba? Hindi pa clear 'yan. Ang ginawa nung author ng libro na 'to, ginaya niya yung sign ng B. Kasi ang B natin negative 3, 'di ba? Ang B natin negative 3, oh. Kaya nilagay dito, 'di ba? Plus B, kaya negative 3 'to. Kasi negative 3 nga yung B natin sa original, sa given. Ginaya niya tong negative. No? Ayan. So, it so happened the numerator here is 15. The numerator, of course, manipulate mo tong numerator, 15 yon. Then, he used, just use negative. What does it mean ambiguous? Pwede mo nga gawing positive yan eh. No? Whether positive or negative, ang sagot niyan, 3. Walang diferensya kasi ang choices, 5. Ano to? Wala, blanco to ah. May 2, tsaka 3. No? Kahit gawin mo tong positive o negative, lalabas yung 3. Kaya lang, ang author ng libro ay nag-assign ng negative. And he said that negative sign implies the point is below the line. Ito. The point is below. Ibig sabihin, nasa ilalim siya. Pag sinabing below, kung nakaharap ka, nasa kanan siya. It's on the right side. Okay? This point is on the right side of the line. Take a look this one. Take a look this. This is a discussion, the principle. The shortest distance from the point to a line. So, of course, again, we are given the equation. In the denominator, use the sign plus, minus. When you will use plus, when you will use minus. Use plus in this denominator, no? This is plus minus. You are going to use plus if B is positive and the point is above. Above. Okay. I will give you a little technique. Okay. We have the XY plane here, right? X and Y plane. X and Y plane. This is X, this is Y. If that is above, nandito sa taas, isn't it positive? Right? Kaalan? Kaalan, kakausapin ko. No? If we mean above, that is positive. If we mean below, negative. Remember, if you are in heaven, that's good. Positive yun. Yeah? If you are in earth, okay, that's negative. In hell, that's bad. That's negative, right? Okay. So, what do I mean? If B is positive, if B is positive daw, kaya nilagay niya yung positive dito eh, no? Nasa handout natin to, di ba? And, the point is above the line, that is again positive. Remember, if the point is above, yung point mo above, that's positive. Take a look in algebra, it's just like multiplication process in algebra. Even like division process. Positive times positive, kaalan. Kaalan, positive times positive, pasagutin natin si kaalan. Para malaman natin kung talagang nagpa-participate. Okay. Are you getting me? Can you follow my discussion? If B is positive, put this positive. Because it's already given B is positive. Positive. And the point is above the line. If the point is above, that's positive. Right? So, positive times positive. What's the answer? Isn't it that it is positive, kaalan? Tama ba? Ay, na-stack up siya. Na-stack up ba? Oo, na-stack up siya. Anyway, para nung isang araw, no, na-stack up si Kawer pangalan. Okay. So, anyway, everybody listen, no, especially to our future REEs, okay, in our Facebook, please listen carefully. If B is positive and the point is below the line, below, of course, sinabi natin kanina, pag above, positive. Pag below, negative. So meaning, B is positive, that's why we have here positive here. The point is below, we have negative. What, therefore, what is positive times negative in algebra? Isn't it that it is negative? Tama, kawer pangalan. Thumbs up nga, kaalan. Yeah, medyo pumupugak din yung connection yata ni Kaalan. Na-stack up ka, Kaalan, ha? Okay. Parehas tayo. Okay. Pwede ka bang magsalita para marinig natin? Magandang boses nito, pang-broadcaster to eh. Hello, Kaalan. Are you following? Nakakasunod ka ba? Can you follow? Hello? Mag-soundcheck ka nga, Kaalan. Para malaman ng ating mga viewers na live tayo. Yan, pasensya na. Ito talaga hirap ng live, ano? May mga technical problems. Anyway, we'll just continue. If B is negative and the point is below the line. Again, there is a word below. B is negative. Put here negative. The point is below. That's why you have negative. Negative times negative. That is positive. Right? Okay? Okay. In algebra, negative times negative, that's positive. Positive times positive, positive. What is that? Like sign, positive. Okay? Unlike sign, negative. Okay? Okay. If B is negative, and the point is above the line, of course, that will be negative. Okay? That is the point there. So, actually, there is no problem, no, if you are going to make this as plus. No? The point of plus is, sir, this should be plus. Let's see, huh? Take a look here. Take a look. It's already given that our B is already negative because that is negative 3. Negative na talaga yung B mo. No? Ngayon, your B is negative. Your B is negative. And your point is below. Your point is below. So therefore, What is this? O, saan ba nabibilang yon? No? So, your B is negative. Your B is negative. And the point below the line, the point is below the line, negative. Therefore, this must be positive. Sino yung positive? Yung nasa ano? After the square root sign, nasa denominator. Okay? So, positive dapat to. Yun yung sabi ni Lance. Tama yung point ni Lance. Kaya lang, may provision naman yung, na may premise, I mean, yung author ng book. This is just an ambiguous sign. Ibig sabihin, unsure pa to. Parang assumption lang niya to. No? Na ginawa niya lang na negative. Pwede mo kang gawing positive ito eh. No? Kasi gawin mo man positive to o negative, na doon pa rin yung magnitude na 3. No? Talagang ang magiging sagot mo, ito sa board exam, 3 talaga. Okay? That is the answer. Now, the author of the book indicates this. The ambiguous sign in the denominator follows the sign of B. Actually, this is another learning, no? Sinunod niya yung sign ng B. Ibig sabihin, kung negative to, negative to. Kung positive to, ipapositive to. There's another learning here. What is this? Solving the distance, okay? If this is negative, negative, he got negative. That's why he put a note here. Negative sign implies the point is below the line. Oh, yun naman pala. No? Eh, yung negative sign naman nito, no? Distance na to eh. Actually, there is no negative distance. Right? It's like a height. Tama ba, Kaalan? Walang negative distance. Wala din negative height. Pare, ano ba height mo? Matangkad ako, Dre. Ano ba height mo? Negative 6 footer ako. Ano yun? Nakabound sa lupa? Negative 6 footer? Okay? So, there's no negative distance. Okay? So, this is the distance of this point to this line. The answer is 3. Okay? He just put another concept here, the author of the book. This is just an ambiguous sign in the denominator. He put here, follows the sign of B. Ibig sabihin, susundin niya yung sign ng B. E negative to, negative din niya ginawa. Para pag nakita niyang negative to, no, the point is below. Diba sabi natin, no? Pag below, negative. Pag above, positive. No? Ganun kasi sa X and Y axis, diba? Pag above, positive yon, positive Y axis yon, diba? Pag below, negative Y axis yon. No? So, I think there's no problem here. No? Okay? So, the author of the book just put an ambiguous or uncertain or unexact assumption of this, no? Okay, Lance. So, kung nasaan ka man, ang ating itong ating kasagutan sa iyong tanong, no? Okay, actually dalawa yung tanong ni Lance, eh, no? So, sana nandito siya, eh, no? So, pero ang tanong niya lang dito actually, sir, tuloy mo lang. So, find the value of K if the distance from the point 2,1 to the line, no? 5X plus 12Y plus K. Unknown tong K, ha? Constant to. Is equal to 0. Actually, kulang nga yung given. Kaalan, ito yung ano, no? Question dun sa pet nyo. Sa pet. Kulang to. So, the distance, dapat may given dito, is 2. Okay? So, ano daw yung value ng K if the distance of the point to the line is 2? So, of course, again, this is the formula. The 2 must be given. Take a look here. Take a look. So, there is a plus here. Okay? Positive. Then he assumes, no? Kasi hindi pa natin alam yung exacto eh, no? Then, sinunod niya itong plus, sinunod niya na lang itong plus na rin ang ginamit dito. No? Plus ang ginamit dyan. Okay? Yun ang kanyang sinunod dito. No? Plus kasi yung B eh, di ba? Ayun, no? Positive 12 plus. Kaya plus na niya ginawa ito. So, ang K natin, 4. So, just manipulating this or just shift solve this in our calculator. No? Actually, wala namang problema dito, no? Okay? So, kulang lang yung given dito sa problem na to. The distance must be 2. Okay? So, I think that's it for today. For our problem, for our questions, no? Okay, dumako po tayo sa ating mga social media comments, no? Mga reactions ng ating mga kawerpa. So, ito po ang ating mga reaction. Okay, tayin natin mga comment nila. Okay, galing kay Mr. Alan Tablada. Salamat sa mga REE and RME mentoring, no? Nakakatulong po ng malaki sa review ko. Kaya hindi ako nasasawa na manood. Palakasin ng buo ang buong MPHT ng ating Panginoon. And galing kay Mr. Joey Reyes Garcia. Napakalaking bagay po na nakaka-attend po ako sa pagkakataon na ito, Kuya Reds, no? Napakalaking tulong po ito sa akin as an ETF graduate. Salamat po. I do believe that the power is in the house. More power, MPHT, God bless you more. Galing kay Mark Anthony Geraldo. Hey, thanks be to God. Marami po kayong power to share the knowledge for free. Maraming student ang matututo sa blessings na ibinabahagi nyo. Salamat ng marami, Kuya Reg. Galing kay Dandan Rivera. Maraming salamat po, Kuya Reg. Isa po ito sa pinakamagandang pagtuturo na narinig ko at free pa. Maraming salamat po. More power. God bless. Galing kay Johan Nerick Estareja, thank you po ng marami, Sir Reg. Napakadami ko pong natutunan. Malaking bagay po ang mga ganitong webinar kasi napakahirap po talagang matuto sa mga platform ngayon. Kaya sobrang laking bagay mga ganitong pagkakataon. Maraming salamat po. God bless. More power to come. Galing kay Princess Ina Juyad. Thank you for free review. Malaking tulong ngayong RME board exam para sa mga nagse-self-review po. Cruz Lexter, salamat Kuya Rez. Napakalaking tulong sa aming mga engineering students, lalo na sa mga major subjects namin. Malaking tulong, lalo na dahil kumpleto sa explanation. Dandan Rivera Baldono, maraming salamat po Kuya Red sa lahat at sa pagtulong sa amin sa paghahanda sa exam. Salamat po ulit. More power po sa MPHT. Galing kay Joey Reyes Garcia. Additional knowledge again Kuya Red. I am grateful to be part of this group. I learned a lot the way you discuss solve all the problem coming from all of us. Thank you again for more power, God bless. Peter Daroy Magbanwa, thank you so much for this special webinar. This encourages me to take the RME or REE board exam for the first time and choosing you to be my mentor in passing the board. Okay, yan po ang ating mga social media comments, no, mga kawerpa. Okay, so okay, this is our review programs, no, our programs and services, no, na may offer namin sa inyo mga kawerpa. So, ito po ang aming mga i-offer po sa inyo. So, meron po tayong free REE and RME online mentoring. So, live po ito via Zoom na ginaganap natin ng every Tuesday partner. Diba, iniba na natin yan. 4 to 6 p.m. po yan, no? Mga ka-wear pa, no? Again, 4 to 6 p.m. na po ang oras po natin ng every Tuesdays and Thursdays. Pag Sunday naman po, ay 11:30 hanggang 1 p.m. po tayo, no? This is guiding every students, every reviewees, no? Guiding you to pass the board exam and also even your college examination, no? This would help. Okay, we have the free 3-in-1. I'm inviting everyone every Sunday to attend our free 3-in-1. So, ano yung tatlo na yun, no? Meron tayong libreng REE or RME review. Kasama na rin po ang ating special topic, a webinar topic. This coming Sunday po ang ating webinar topic ay yung PEC 2017 Wiring Design Examples number 2 and 3. I-discuss ko po sa inyo yan, no? Yung mismong nasa likod ng Philippine Electrical Code 2017, mga ka-wear pa, no? So, and meron pa rin tayong RE and RME mentoring ng every Sunday. Ayan. So, first come, first serve basis po tayo dito, mga ka-wear pa. Okay, so we have the promote ko, electrical products mo. So, dito, mga ka-wear pa, no? Yung mga electrical suppliers namin, naayayahan namin kayo, no? Sana pwede tayong maging ka-partner sa pagbibigay ng kaalaman sa ating mga ka-werpa, no? So, yung inyong produkto po ay ating ile-lecture, i-discuss, at pwede rin po kayo, bibigyan namin kayo ng enough time para mag-discuss patungkol sa inyong produkto, ma-market ninyo ang inyong produkto, no? Sa ating pong mga viewers, no? Mga nakikinig. No, actually on the average maabot tayo na more than 1000 views sa ating Facebook Live, no? At sa ating YouTube channel po, nung isang araw naka 2000 plus pa tayo na views, no? At sa atin naman pong Facebook sa ating YouTube channel, I mean, meron na po tayong more than 1700 subscribers, no? And still counting, no? And meron tayong around 10,000 views sa atin pong YouTube channel, no? So I'm inviting everyone, no? Yung mga electrical suppliers, makipag tulungan po kayo sa amin. Libre po, wala po kaming i-charge sa inyo kahit 5 sa pagpo-promote ng inyong produkto dito sa aming ginaganap na mga public services, no? Nahandog po sa atin lahat ito ng UN Television. Ito pong mga pre-services ng powerhouse ay sa pakikipag-ugnayan ng UNTV. Your public service channel, no? Handog po sa atin ito. Okay, ng Channel 37 UN Television. Okay. So, meron po tayong special webinar. Actually, right after this mentoring program, meron po kami mga ka-werpa na mga special webinar, no? Gusto nyo pong humabol sa aming pong Industrial Motor Control special webinar for today. No? Pwede pa pong humabol, mga ka-werpa, no? Hanggang alas 11 po ng gabi yan, gagawin namin, no? Pwede po kayong mag-join. Then, every month, meron po kaming monthly topics na ito, no? Building Wiring Installation, Industrial Motor Control, Practical Electrical Design for Buildings, and Practical Electrical Estimation Course. So, yan po ang apat na parati naming kinoconduct every month, no? Baka gusto nyo pong mag-join sa aming special webinar. Murang-mura lamang po, no? 4,000 pesos lang po ang apat po na yan, mga ka-werpa, no? Ang building wiring natin is only 700 pesos. Ang ating industrial motor control is only 800 pesos. Ang ating electrical design course is only 1,500. Ang ating electrical estimation is 1,000 pesos, no? Libre na po ang mga soft copy ng ating mga lecture materials, no? Pati yung ating e-certificate at yung ating mga videos na mga additional free videos na ibibigay po sa inyo, mga ka-werpa, no? Via YouTube link, no? Bibigyan po namin kayo ng mga libreng video, no? Napakamurang halaga at napakarami pong free na makukuha po kayo dito po sa aming ginaganap na mga special webinar. And mind you, yung aming pong mga lectures dito ay wala sa aking YouTube channel. Wala po yan. No? Exclusive po itong lectures po na ito para po sa inyo na mag-a-avail ng ating special webinar. No, monthly po namin binibigay po ito, mga kawerpa. No, usually weekdays ng gabi, 6 p.m. onwards, no, usually. Okay? Okay, so ayan po yung atin pong mga course outline, mga kawerpa, no? Baka maitanong nyo kung ano ba yung mga topics na i-discuss namin, no? So andyan naman po at nasa atin naman pong Facebook Live yan, no? Pwede sa ating Facebook account, I mean, sa ating Facebook page ng Marinized Powerhouse, makikita nyo po yung mga yan, no? Para makita nyo kung anong laman ng ating mga special webinars, no? At meron pa rin po tayo mga kawerpa na special promo, no, sa ating online review via Zoom, no? So special promo po natin hanggang December 24, no? Okay, baka may gustong humabol mga kawerpa, no? Baka abutan kayo ng Pasko, no? So hanggang December 24 lang po ito, no? So REE review and refresher course, it's only 13,000 pesos. Ayan, no? Pwede naman, no? Sir, kung review course lang ang aming i-avail, no? It's only 9,000 pesos, no? Pero mas malaki po ang matitipid natin kung i-avail natin ang review kasama na ang refresher course, no? 4,000 pesos po ang inyong discount. Sa RME naman, 3,000 ang inyong discount kung kayo mag-a-avail ng RME review plus refresher course. Ayan, ano? Okay. At sa atin naman pong, ito po yung ngayon lang namin ipapakita sa inyo, mga kawerpa. No? Ito yung napakagandang balita na handog na naman sa atin po ng UN Television. No? Nagkaroon po, actually, meron po tayong scholarship na ginanap, no? Na meron po tayong screening. Ang tabay lang po sa mga iba pa po na hindi pa po natin. Huwag po kayo mawala ng pag-asa. No? So, medyo nagkaroon lang ng konting delay sa selection ng ating mga scholars, no? Yung iba nga nakapasok na, no? So, lalo sa REE, sa January pa naman po ang start ng isang section, nahabol po ang ating mga kawerpa na mga nag-apply sa ating REE-RME. At ngayon, pangatlong scholarship natin, handog sa atin ng UN Television partner, no? Ang ating Let Online Review Scholarship Program via Zoom. This is for March 2021 licensure exam for teachers. Ayan po, no? Kasi alam nyo, mga kawerpa, apat ang aming review program po sa Powerhouse, no? REE, RME, Master Plumber, at LET. Nag-conduct na rin po kami ng LET before, no? Naka ilang batches na rin kami, naka limang batches na po kami yan, no? So this will be our sixth batch na, pero ang gagawin po natin dito, no? Pabayaran tayo ng UNTV sa scholarship na ito, no? Wala po kayong babayaran, no? Bahala po ang UNTV diyan, no? Sila po ang magbabayad sa amin, no? Para makapagpatuloy ang program po na ito, no? So libre po, wala po kayong babayaran, mga kawerpa, no? Ayan, review now, pay never, no? So, ang mga topics po, yung inyo pong mga subjects category na ito, yung general education and professional education, no? So, how is this, no? Attend po kayo ng aming orientation day, no? Yan, ha? Sana wag na kayong magtanong kung how, ha? How? Umattend na lang kayo. Ayan na po, nandyan na ang mga Zoom ID. Dalawang batch po ang i-open namin, mga kawerpa, no? Sa ating mga kawerpa, mga electrical practitioner natin, baka meron kayong misis, graduate ng education, no? Kakilala, graduate ng education, whether elementary or high school education, tutulungan po namin sila with the help of UN Television, no? Ililibre po natin. Paatinin nyo po sila sa December 28, 5 to 7 p.m., no? Ayan na po ang Zoom ID, open to the public, no? At kung hindi sila pwede ng December 28, on January 1, meron pa rin, no? So, January 1, 5 to 7 p.m., yan, ayan na po ang atin pong Zoom meeting ID. No? Join na lang po kayo kagad, ganun lang po kasimple yan. Ano? Pwede po kayong mag-attend, no? ng ating ano, doon nyo na po malalaman ng detalye, lahat ng detalye patungkol po dito sa orientation day po natin. No? So, I'm inviting everyone no, to attend our orientation day for our soon-to-be no, registered professional teachers. Okay? So, ito'y handog sa atin ng UN Television, your public service channel. Okay, we also have Master Plumber Review, mga kawerpa, na actually, ang aming Master Plumber ay magsisimula sa bandang April para sa July board examination po ito. No? Baka may mga interested po sa inyo dyan, no? You may contact us. Okay, tuloy-tuloy pa rin po ang ating sales ng ating mga books po, REE books natin. No? Baka may gusto pong mag-avail po sa inyo, mga kawerpa. Okay? So, ayan po ang mga umorder ng ating mga books. Okay? Then, meron din tayong Master Electrician books. Ayan po. Mga powerful books na po yan. No? It contains the past and possible board exam problems from year 1990s. Kasi lumalabas pa rin po mga questions noong 1990s hanggang 2019. Ayan po, mga kawerpa. No? Then, meron din po tayong Master Plumber books. Ayan po, yung apat na yan. Mga kawerpa, okay, ito po ang mga bumili, ang ating book, at yung ating pong YouTube channel, no, sana po kayo mag-subscribe, mag-like, comment, and share, ano po, sa aking pong YouTube channel, the Reggie Marina YouTube channel, no, we already uploaded almost 200 videos, no, marami po kayo matututunan at tuloy-tuloy po kami mag-upload sa loob po ng isang linggo, mga 3 to 4 times a week, nag-upload po kami ng mga videos, mga kawerpa. You may visit, no? You may watch our videos for free. You can download it, no? You can own it for free, mga kawerpa, no? And at sana ma-share po ninyo at kung po pwede, panoorin nyo na rin po yung aming mga commercials, no? At magbigay po kayo ng comment, no? Hindi pera, no? comment. Magbigay kayo ng inyong mga comment sa bawat video na mapapanood po ninyo. Ulitin ko lang, baka pwede pong panoorin nyo na rin, segundo lang naman ang mga commercials ng ating pong mga videos. Okay, with this, we should say thanks be to God, mga kawerpa. Maraming maraming salamat po sa pag-attend ng ating pong REE and RME online mentoring. Magkita-kita tayo this coming Sunday, mga kawerpa. No? 8:30 to 1. Mahaba po ang ating linggo, no? 8:30 to 1, no? Kasi 3-in-1 po yung ating program. Pagka libre po yan, no? Handog sa atin ng UN Television, no? Your public service channel. Okay, maraming maraming salamat po mga kawerpa sa inyong panonood, ating mga kaibigan, mga kawerpa natin sa Facebook. Maraming salamat po. God bless you all. Thank you.